Why is Pharrell? Gamey. Why would you settle for less?
Leading wide receivers from that highly rated wide receiver draft class of 2014. It's Sammy Watkins going up against Mike Evans.
All right, Larry, we are at a site that's played host to two Super Bowls, and that's Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with the Buffalo Bills. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was. First carry for LeSean McCoy. And he'll take this up only to...
It's out of it. Because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Why is for real? Game.
Down, last one, that hurts. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Following the interception. The play fake to Sims. Now Winston.
They'll start the drive with a little juke. So he got free at one tack.
More movement, more elusiveness. That allowed him to make the play there for a short gain.
And some extras coming up on the line here, ready for the blitz. Here's Taylor. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground. You can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and wearing relief was incredible. Ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I'd missed him, it would have been a story. Long night.
On first and 10, it's... resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Hey, you're so right, because you really need the rush to almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. It's caught by Mike Evans. Fresh set of downs. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Here's Winston. It's brought in by Adam Humphries. And he gets this in of 15 yards, and the sticks move. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Working out of the gun, Winston. He gets it to Humphries. 17 more yards.
Receiver, but you know something, that guy who's covering you, he's usually pretty good too. So the corner route is usually a great spot to get it done.
They go play action here on first down. Flushed out right. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second
down. And he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
Second down, Winston. And incomplete there.
It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
The first carry here for Jaquizz Rodgers. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
Good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
And Aguayo's kick is good. And they are on the board, trailing now at 6-3. So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
That's fielded in the end zone. It'll bring it back to just about seconds to go, first quarter. Down with McCoy. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Here's Taylor to throw. Complete here to the right to Bolden. And he'll get.
Here we go.
On second down, it's McCoy. And they'll be in.
So right now, what I'm seeing an offense just firing off the ball a lot quicker than they can react. And not only that, they're sustaining the blocks, too. I'm seeing guys get 6-7 yards downfield before there's even a hint of first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
Here we go.
A fake to McCoy. Now it's Taylor. The swing pass caught. And all the way. Line up now for the 2-point try. Taylor, and this is going to be caught. It's good. And that extends their lead by 2 more. Here's Hauschka now to kick it away. And this will not be returned to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on everyone.
Play fake. Winston. Get to him. Kyle.
Every now and then, you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now, if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was 3rd and 10 versus 3rd and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling.
Had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Now Taylor throwing the out route incomplete. That's Brown. First down carry here for McCoy. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line.
Extremely vital. I love how you describe that because if they control things up front, often it's over the guard. Sometimes they slide and make it over the center. It's really hard to get a play started then because a lot of teams want to start inside out running the football. But against a good 4-3, you may not.
The throw is Taylor. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't fork down. Colton Schmidt to punt it away. Adam Humphries deep for Tampa Bay. And a fair catch signaled for and taken at about the 18-yard line. Carry here for Charles Sims, and he's taken after this timeout. A first down throw for Winston. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into end. Short gain there down to the 30.
They've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Now a second down throw for Winston. And his throw's going to be incomplete. And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. On third down, Winston. He's got Evans. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. A familiar ring to that one. Winston to Evans for the Buccaneer first. Now a play fake here on first down. For the point after. And he's got it. That cuts the lead. It's now 14-10. The kicker, Roberto Aguayo, has it teed up and is about ready to get this one started. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll make it. We'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee.
Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Now Taylor on first down. Forced out to his left. And time five. Behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12.
Let's go.
Now Taylor. Wide open is Watkins. He's got 15 seconds to play in half number one. On first down, it's Taylor. His throw caught in about the five. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the four-yard line.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. And break. The tight end's got it. And he'll get it into enemy territory.
You can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Here comes the D swarming to the line. Winston now. A dump off to Sims. And he's brought down. Give him 12.
It is a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And now second down. Now Jameis on second down. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. Needing a big play after the sack as he leads the Bucs up on third and long. Winston steps away to his left and able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. Now on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Now this is good. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude. And they're on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
They'll go again to McCoy. Operates in the red zone.
Ready. Ready.
Now they run with Sims, and he'll wind up losing.
You know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. And that is.
And go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Is down to one now at 14-13. So they recover the fumble but could not take advantage of the short field. They do get three.
And no one ever turns down 3 points going up on the board, but the offense will go to the sidelines wondering what if, while the defense on the other side, they'll celebrate holding them to just a field goal after giving up such bad field position.
On the return, it's Brandon Tate. And he's going to get taken down inside the 10 at about the 8.
You're not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
Off the play fake, here's Taylor. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he's able to get this one almost in 10 now.
Here we go.
10th carry now for McCoy. The broken tackle, but couldn't create much space.
Once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Let's go!
Again, it's McCoy. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Back now in Tampa. This one's still anybody's ball. Third and 10. A big play to start the drive, but nothing since. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got to jump.
They're pretty cagey, too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
Here we go.
Taylor. And this is going to be it. Here's Colton Schmidt now as he'll punt it away for the second time. Oh, he takes it in, doesn't let it bounce. He takes it at the two. A big boot back out onto the field. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. From the shotgun, it's Winston. Jackson's got it over the middle. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is... Humphreys goes in motion. They'll run it. And Sims lost it. He lost the football. And great field position coming up in the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
And he's heating up at the line of scrimmage.
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Went backwards 7 yards on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 16.
Let's go.
From the gun, it's Taylor. Can't find a receiver, and he's brought long, and they're going to go for it. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Let's go.
They'll try and throw for it with Taylor. And that is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had
to be a full evaluation of their team. Do they trust their defense in this situation? Maybe they think they've given all they can in this game and they don't have anything left. Do they not trust that the other team's quarterback?
And they're taken down. The Bills get to him.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Here's Winston, bringing it in, Jackson left side. It'll be a pickup of 15, as that'll lead.
Always a big part of his game.
Talking about speed, only Tyreek Hill was measured with a faster play last year than DeSean Jackson, who hit 22.6 miles per hour on a touchdown versus the Cardinals in week 13. And incomplete, the contact. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Got his man complete over the middle. We're back to see what happens after this. Back to throw. Slings one that's incomplete. Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation. Not nearly enough time on the clock. You have to really navigate against a tough defense presented against you.
And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48.
Gain, short gain, last two plays. Who do you think's excited about that?
Absolutely, this defense. They're saying go right ahead with those. He's back to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Jackson. And he'll be taken down, but not... They'll run it now, out of the gun. Down right around on this drive, coming up. They'll look to throw. Throw left side complete. It's Jackson. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard here. loop. The kicker, Roberto Aguayo, has it teed up and is about ready to get this one started. Short kick. One of the up middle take it down. And when the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice.
And this will be caught at the 30. And now before this first...
Ha 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 ha!